Visual and auditory learning are two of the most common ways in which individuals are educated and taught new skills. Visual learners receive best results when the skill is demonstrated to them. They then interpret and perceive what relative motions and movement patterns are required for adequate execution. Auditory learners see results when they are hearing and listening to the environment and the instructor about the execution of the skill. Both part and whole practice concepts are associated with various motor learning principles and are prescribed in accordance with the skill needing to be executed. Whole practice refers to the continued practice of the whole skill, whereas part practice looks at breaking down the skill into components. Both whole and part practice methods provide significant improvements in performance, and it is important to use both concepts and identify what would work best for the learning stage of the individual. Coordination and sequencing are crucial in any sport as it allows for smooth patterning and movement due to a combination of muscles acting together with appropriate intensity and timing. Coordination involves balance of activation and inhibition of muscles. It also minimizes overflow to the other muscles. Flexibility and strength must first be achieved before appropriate proprioception and coordination skills can be developed. Variable practice is when one skill or task is repeated, however one aspect changes from one repetition to another. Variable practice is more beneficial than that of constant practice. Variable exercise is meant to have more performance errors rather than skill errors occurring, which is most beneficial in the initial stages of learning, especially with our patient, who is considered to be retraining and relearning a new skill to prevent further injury. Feedback is crucial within various stages of learning in order for the athlete to receive optimum results and enhance performance. There are many different types of feedback, including intrinsic and extrinsic feedback, as well as knowledge of results and knowledge of performance. Proprioception also plays a large role in feedback. Proprioception is the perception of limbs, trunk and head in relation to the direction, location in space and velocity of movement. It is an important source of intrinsic feedback. Knowledge of results and knowledge of performance are augmented extrinsic feedback. Knowledge of results is knowledge of the outcome, while knowledge of performance is knowledge of how the movement was performed. It can be delivered concurrently during the movement, immediately after, or delayed. Random practice is a type of training option that can be taken to increase the amount of contextual interference. When the contextual interference is high in random organisation of practice, this means that trials involve performing a variety of tasks in one session rather than one task being the main and only focus for one session. It was initially suggested that low contextual interference, therefore block practice, would lead to better learning. However, this was further researched by Shea and Morgan, where it was concluded that although there is poorer performance during random practice, there is a greater amount of learning and transfer retention when random practice is the principle for load. The skill specificity principle suggests that the more physical and cognitive characteristics that skills and situations have in common, the greater amount of transfer of learning or performance there is. There has been a sufficient amount of research to support the practice specificity hypothesis increases motor skill learning and performance by affecting three main characteristics, which are sensory and perceptual characteristics, context characteristics, and cognitive processing characteristics. Transfer of learning is a widely used principle throughout rehabilitation, education, and sports training. Transfer of learning refers to the ability to be able to transfer learned skills from a past experience or situation to another current environment or situation to see optimum results. As our athlete is injured, the transfer of learning may be positive or negative. A positive effect may occur by having progression through the taxonomy stages, providing the injury is healing well, or it could have a negative effect, as the motor learning pattern from the past experience could be what led to the injury in the first place. Therefore, it is important that this pattern is broken in order to enhance future performance.
We're going to start strengthening up your shoulder muscles again. So we're going to look at some isometric contractions, which is a different type of exercise that I'm going to take you through. Now what we're going to do to begin with, we're going to get you to put this just under your elbow. So it's just going to sit about here. Yep, just so that every time you do the exercise, yep, that's fine. Yep, just so every time you do the exercise, you're not changing the angle between your elbow and the side of the trunk.
Mm-hmm.
So what we're going to do, we're going to do some isometric stuff. So what that means is I'm going to get you to hold your arm at about, say, 50%, trying to push against the pole, just to strengthen your shoulder a little bit. Once you've done this one, we're going to do it for 5 seconds. So we'll do this one for 5 seconds, and then we're just going to shuffle you along a bit, and we're going to go back the other way for 5 seconds, and we're going to do 5 trials on each side.
Sure.
So first things first, I'm just going to line you up. So if you just want to put your elbow at a 90 degree angle for me, yep, with your wrist just on the thing. Now I'm just going to do this so that every time you do it, you're hitting the same spot every single time.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so how does that feel? Do you feel all right with that in your arm?
Yep.
All right, so if you want to put your...
In this video, we focused on auditory and visual learning, so the instructor demonstrated as well as verbally told the patient how to do the skill, and we also look at whole and part practice. So this is where we've broken down the skill, and we've just cut it back to do some isometric training to strengthen the muscles. Throughout the next couple of videos, we're just taking you through the next stages of our Gentiles taxonomy and showing how our patient is progressing. I'm gonna fight them all. I said the nation army couldn't hold me back. They're gonna rip it off. Taking their time right behind my back. And I'm talking to myself at night because I can't forget. Back and forth through my mind behind a cigarette. In the next video, it's going to be demonstrating how we took our subject through stage 2B of Gentiles Taxonomy.
We're going to take our training session just a little bit more advanced. The exercise that we did the other week where we were doing our hop face with no band, we're going to add the band into it now.
Cool.
So same things apply, nice straight wrist the whole time. Try and imagine that you're keeping space between your shoulder and your ear the whole time as well, and then we'll avoid that little shift up. See how we go. Just do a few where you're going through your pop face yourself. Imagine the different numbers, elbows going to lead, then open out, just like we did before, and then I'll start yelling out some clock numbers for you to hit.
In this video, we're using a variety of principles, including visual and auditory learning, whole and part practice, proprioceptive feedback, and a bit of variable practice also, where the instructor is saying numbers and the athlete has to respond to these numbers correctly.
Okay, I think we're probably ready to have a go at yelling out a few little numbers. So if we think 12 is up and we're heading down towards 6 o'clock, so let's go for a 3 o'clock first.
In this video, we have also started to include random practice where there is more contextual interference, which makes it harder for the individual to complete the task without errors. In the next few videos, we are just taking the subject through our other stages of Gentiles taxonomy. Again, we're still using the principles as listed before, and we're also starting to incorporate some specificity into the training. In the following video, it's going to demonstrate how we took our subject through step 3C of Gentiles taxonomy.
Into more sport-specific type training, obviously with the totem tennis pole, it's going to start feeling a little bit more realistic, which is good. I also want to see a little bit of weight transfer through your body,
yep.
So just movement really through the legs will get that going, because that's going to make it feel more game-like as well.
Yep.
So get you back into these patterns, so then when we finish the rehab, you can go out and feel confident in your next slot of training.
Yep.
So today, what we're going to do is I'm going to release the ball from this side,
yep.
And I want you to strike the ball, mainly focusing on accuracy,
yep.
not necessarily speed. So we'll do 5 forehands, and then I'll get it back, and we'll work on 5 back.
Yep.
Okay. No problem. So I'll just show you.
Yep.
As well. So all I'm going to do is release the ball from this side, and I want to strike the forehand.
Yep, so just like that.
Yep,
yep.
So,
and did you want me to hit the ball? Or?
No, I'll just get you to stand off a little bit, but just doing exactly how you would do that.
Yep.
Okay?
Yep.
No worries. So we'll just do one practice one, and then we'll go into our 5 forehand pass and our 5 back.
No problem.
Yep, perfect.
Yep, just like that.
Okay, here we go.
In this video, we have continued to use the previously listed principles, as well as focusing on skill specificity predominantly. We've also incorporated auditory feedback, as well as looking at sequencing and coordination and speed versus accuracy. In the following videos, we are just taking our athlete through the last and final stages of Gentiles taxonomy to prepare them for returning to training. We are also continually focusing on the principles already listed. In the following video, we are taking the athletes through stage 4D of Gentiles taxonomy. At the end of this video, it would be expected that the athlete would be ready to return to training to prepare for competition.
So you're obviously familiar with the total terms file now from our exercises previously.
Yep.
So now it's going to get a bit more fun, a bit more interactive, because you're actually pretty much in a game-like situation,
yep.
Although we're still in the clinic and whatnot.
Yep.
But this will get you moving forward so we can get you out back onto the court.
Yep.
So today you get a real tennis racket
awesome.
As well.
Thank you.
So here's what we're going to do. Is it's pretty much just at very height, so
yep.
It's going to go up and down. This will also mean that you can do both forehand and backhand in one set, one series of practice,
yep.
Which is going to be really good for you because obviously throughout the game you'll be not just hitting forehand or not just hitting backhand the whole time
yep.
as well. Also we're going to work just for the first 30 seconds on making sure you've got the correct technique. Movement through that shoulder's correct, so you've got the right movement pattern to avoid any other injuries.
Yep.
And then after that, I'll stop you and we'll work more towards a bit of speed and getting more like game lock.
No problem.
Cool. Alright. I'll just release it to start and then you're on your own.
Yep.
So I'll just be looking at you from afar. Is that okay?
Yep.
In this video, we incorporate all the principles previously talked about and would expect that the athlete would almost be at full function, ready to return to training. It was important that in this video, the athlete was completing the skill at full function with correct speed and timing of sequences. At the end of this video, a checklist was also completed to make sure that the athlete was completely ready for returning to training where they will see optimum results.